So let's go for the last presentation, which is about Mikado software. The Mikado software is used to generate CDataNet metadata files. Here is an overview of my presentation. First, I will remind you Mikado main feature and principles. Then I will present Mikado last developments and main changes. And after, I will give you some recommendations about EDMED, IDOS, and CDI content. And I will highlight some reoccurring mistakes. And after that, we will make some exercises. Mikado is used to generate XML description for all the CDataNet catalogs, CSR, EDMED, CDI, NMAP, and IDOS. Is written in Java and is available under multiple environments. It can be used in interactive and batch modes. Mikado uses the CDataNet command vocabulary's web services to update its list of values. Mikado needs a network connection in order to have up-to-date list of values, but it can work offline once the lists are up-to-date. Mikado can be used in two different ways. One manual way for users who have a small amount of entries. In that case, user has to input information manually in the Mikado interface. And Mikado can be used in one automatic way to generate automatically XML description for information referenced in a database or in a CSV file. In that case, you have to write SQL queries in Mikado in order to interrogate your database and get the information necessary to the CDataNet catalogs. The current release of Mikado is 3.5.1. It's freely available on the CDataNet website. A user manual is also provided in which you can find a lot of details and a lot of snapshots. And we have also a FAQ web page that is updating regularly. For your information, since the last CDataNet 2 training session, Mikado have been released 4 times. Since the last MONET chemistry training session, Mikado have been released 3 times. And the present version have been released last week. I will focus on the main changes in Mikado and not go into the detail of the bug correction. So in Mikado 3.4, we have upgraded all the database drivers. We have implemented a new facility to import directly the NeMo CDI summary file in Mikado. In Mikado 3.5, we have added a report for vocabulary updates, and we made an improvement to avoid some reoccurring errors. I'm going to give you more details. So the first main changes is upgrade of the database drivers. All the database driver have been upgraded in Mikado because they started to become old and we had more and more problems. So now all the driver are up to date. A big changes in Mikado is that The driver for Excel is no more provided, so the connection to Excel files are no more possible, because JDBC connectivity to Excel is no more maintained by Java. So you Excel user have to find alternative solution to connect Mikado to their files. Alternative solution have been described in the user manual of Mikado and will be demonstrated during this training session. One of the alternative solution is to use a CSV file instead of Excel file, and that's why we add a new driver in Mikado to connect the CSV file. Just to illustrate, now Excel is no more supported by Mikado, and so you have to use a CSV file or a real database. Here is a snapshot of the new CSV connection button in Mikado. Another change in Mikado is the implementation of a new facility to import directly the NIMU CDI summary file that you have generated this morning, and to generate automatically the corresponding SQL queries. Previously, Nemo provided the CSV file, but the user must have converted this CSV file into Excel file to connect it to Mikado. And the user has also have to update the configuration file that, delivered by Nemo to connect the Excel file. So we have removed two steps. Now you can directly connect the CDI summary CSV file generated by Nemo in Mikado. And Mikado will generate automatically the configuration file. So how to use this facility? You have to go to the automatic menu of Mikado, click on new, and you have now a new item in the menu. It's CDI from Nemo export. You have to select the Nemo CDI summary. It imported in Mikado. You just have to check the connection. And the SQL queries are automatically generated, and the configuration file is automatically created and saved by Mikado. You just have to check the queries. Another change in Mikado concerns the vocabulary update. As I said previously, Mikado uses the CDataNet command vocabulary web services to update its list of values. To update the Mikado vocabulary list, you can go in the option menu and choose vocabulary update. Previously, we had just a scroll bar indicated the progress of the vocabulary update, but we had no information about which lists have been updated, and no information when the update failed. So we try to improve it, and now you will have a complete report during the vocabulary update. A green report means that everything is okay. This report indicates you which list need to be updated or not. For example, here, P02, no need to be updated. And you can see that P01 have been updated. If you have a red report, something doesn't work. So you have to study the report to find the problem, which can come from the BODC or MARIS services, or come from your computer. Is not a real problem because Mikado is continuing to work with the latest version of the vocabularies, but if you need a new parameter code, for example, or something like that, you have to wait to solve this problem. We have tried to improve something in Mikado because CDataNet Helpdesk receive a lot of messages from users who encounter that type of errors because some field in CDI and CSR must be extracted for your database as a date format and not as a date time format. The concern variable is here. Mikado expect a date and your query return a date time. So with the feedback of user, we realize that error message was not easily understandable, clearly, and the error messages appear during the XML generation, even if all was okay during checking the queries. So we have changed that, and now the error message will appear during the query checking, and we try to put a message more understandable for user. Now I will try to give you some best practices and recommendations about EdMed, EDIOS, and CDI content. The slide have been provided by BODC. So for EdMed, BODC asks you to consider appropriate granularity for your EdMed in order to facilitate discovery of suitable packages of data. BODC recommends also to search the catalog before compiling new records because an appropriate record may already exist. We recommend also to use Mikado to extract and update your record from the EdMed database and do not update local copies. If your EdMed information is stored in a database, make sure that in your local database your local database is kept updated with the feedback received from BODC in order to avoid to resend the same error next time. The dataset name should describe the content of the dataset and provide spatial and temporal information. Abstract should include the what, where, when, how, and who of the dataset. Informative abstracts helps to sell datasets. And finally, please refer also to EdMed guidance notes on the CIDATANET website to help you to submit your EdMed entries. Concerning EDIOS, an imminent review of the EDIOS schema structure is planned. Some changes may be ahead to ensure the schema remains fit for purpose. BODC will be engaging with CData Cloud partner in due course to refresh existing EDIOS content and encourage new content. The Mikado manual should always be consulted when creating and updating records. And please refer also to EDIOS guidance notes on the CIDATANET website. And to finish with EDIOS, just a common misconception. Program entries do not need to be ingested by the central catalog before creating your series and platform entries. In Mikado, you have to create first your program for EDIOS, and after you can create series and platform, and you can send all the package to BODC. What about CDI? This slide have been provided by Maris. Some common CDI errors are listed. For example, we find values unknown or blank where information is probably available. For example, we can find in CDI abstract not specified. So please try to fill out at least a general description of the dataset. Concerning the geographical coordinate, often coordinates are located on land or in a different area than reported. Sometimes measuring area type not corresponding with the instrument. For example, we can find CTD as a curve measurement, bathymetry as a point measurement. So you have to check all this potential error. The local CDI ID should have correct syntax. The correct syntax is given on the slide. If you use Mikado, the syntax will be correct. The cruise and station start date can be also incorrect. For example, we can find measurement before start date of the cruise or of the station. Sometimes local CDI ID are not unique. And in case of update, IDs not kept the same to previous deliveries. And I suggest you to refer to the CDI metadata generation FAQ on the Maris website. To complete, I would like to add something about the CSR and EdMed references in CDI files. Since 2013, every CDI can be linked to a CSR reference or an EdMed reference. Mikado allow you to input information about these references. And we will make some exercise about this. Even if these fields are not mandatory, I recommend you to provide information to fulfill that field in order to have a complete CDI, to have more information in your CDIs. Here is an example of a CDI entry with an EdMed reference, and you can click on it, and you go to the EdMed directory. And the same here, we have a CDI with a cruise summary report reference, and we can go to the corresponding entry in the CSR catalog. So that's all for my presentation. So if you have questions, I can answer now, or we can go to the hands-on session as you want. So during this hands-on session, I propose you to make three exercises if we have time. The first one concerns Nemo Mikado interaction. It's the generation of CDI XML files for XBT data collected during the Kalmar cruise using the Nemo summary file. The second one is the addition of CSR and MED references in the CDI generated in the exercise one. And the exercise three will concern more Excel user. It's implementation of alternative solutions for Excel users. So now you can take your CDI summary file generated by Mikado this morning. If you did not succeed to generate it, I provide you with this file on the classroom Mikado on the Ocean Teacher. And I invite you to follow the first step, which is create a new configuration file using this TXT file. So to do that, go to the automatic menu of Mikado and select New and CDI from Nemo Export. And select the CDI summary from Nemo. So Mikado creates automatically a configuration file at the same place than the Nemo summary file. And you can check the connection in the connection tab and check the queries directly in Mikado. Normally, you must have green messages. So the step two is the generation of CDI XML files. Use the automatic menu and select Generate CDI. Select the configuration file automatically created by Mikado. So now you can send your CDI files to Maris, and it's finished. You can just to see the XML file, you can open one of the XML files in Mikado manual, for example, using manual menu, open CDI, and select an XML file. And you can see that most of the information are fulfilled. The second exercise in this second exercise, you had to add a CSR reference and an EnMed reference in the CDI XML file generated with the Nemo summary file. First, you can do it using Mikado manual. So you have to open one of the CDI XML file using the manual menu open CDI and go to the crew station tab. You can add your CSR reference by clicking on this button. And you can search the Calma 97 in the drop-down list. You can search by name or by local ID or central ID. When you find it, you can select it. In order to set a filter in the CSR list, you have to use asterisk and then return to go to the next match. If it's not clear for you, do not hesitate to ask me. I can show you how to search in the Mikado list. You have a green message at the bottom of the CSR list to indicate how to filter the list. We can do the same with EdMed reference. So go to Others tab and click on the Edit button. Open the EdMed list. Set the filter using asterisk. And you can search by local ID or central ID. I did not give you the name of the EdMed because it's quite long. So now you can save the XML file using manual menu and save or save as option. I invite you to open the XML file using a text editor or Internet Explorer, for example, and look for the EdMed and CSR references. You can look for SDN underscore CSR code keyword, for example. Now I propose to make the same exercise, but in Mikado Automatic. Please open the configuration file created by Mikado during the exercise 1. Using automatic menu, open CDI. And add a CSR reference using the variable 81. Using one of the following information, cruise name, CSR local ID, or CSR central ID. To do so, I recommend you to click on existing query, for example, the query for variable 1. Click on the plus button at the right of the query select the variable 81. And enter, for example, the cruise name using quote marks. Do not forget to use quote marks, because in that case, we put value as hard-coded values. So it's important to use quote marks. In this exercise, we used the cruise name as a hard-coded value, but if you have this information in your database, you can use the database field directly in the SQL query to get the information for your database. And in this case, do not use a quote mark. Now you can add also an EnMed reference using the variable 80. You can use a local ID or central ID. In the same way, you have to select an existing query, for example, the query with variable 1. Click on the plus button on the right of the query. Select variable 80. And input the local ID or central ID using quote marks. So once you have added the CSR reference and EnMed reference in your queries, you can check the queries using the check button or check all button. Normally, you will have a green message. If you have green message, you can save the configuration file and generate the XML files. During the generation of XML files, Mikado will certainly ask you for mapping. If you use, for example, cruise name or local ID in the queries, Mikado is not able to know which CSR EnMed entry corresponds. So you have to tell him the mapping. So you have to enter the mapping for CSR reference and also for EnMed reference. To avoid mapping, I recommend you to use central ID or the concatenation of edmocode underscore local ID. In that way, Mikado will be able to recognize your CSR or EnMed reference and will not ask you for mapping. So you can also open the XML file generated using text editor or Internet Explorer and look for your CSR and EnMed references. So now in your CDIs, you have information about the related CSR entries and the related EnMed entry. So you have linked the catalogs. You can find quite easily the CDI you have generated using the CDI portal by searching Kalmar 97 in the free search field and by selecting the Batty Thermograph instrument type in here. You can show the CDI record here. You will find here the EnMed reference that you have added in the CDI XML file. and you can go to the EdMed catalog, and you can find the reference to the cruise and the link to the CSR entry. So that's all for the second exercise. I propose to begin the exercise 3, but we have no time to finish because it's time to close the Mikado presentation. Just some words. As I said previously, Excel, the connection to Excel file is no more possible in Mikado. So I would like to suggest you alternative solution. We have two different cases. The first one if you use an Excel file with only one sheet. In that case, the alternative solution is quite simple, is to convert your Excel file into CSV file to be connected with Mikado. The case number two is Excel file with several sheets. In that case, you cannot convert your file into a CSV file. So the easier solution for you is to try to merge your different sheets in only one sheet and to convert it into CSV file. Or you store your metadata in a database instead of Excel file. You can use OpenOffice database, Microsoft Office Access, MySQL, all the drivers to connect these databases are provided with Mikado. We can make the exercise for the case number one. You can find in the Ocean Teacher, in the Mikado folder, you can find an Excel file, CDI summary Excel file. And you can find also an XML file, which is a configuration file for Mikado. The first step is to convert the Excel file into CSV file using Microsoft Office Excel or OpenOffice Calc. You open the Excel file and save as CSV. I'm going to pass case number two because we have no time to do that. It's quite long. So once you have converted your Excel file into CSV file, you can open the provided configuration file in Mikado Automatic. Automatic menu, select Open, CDI, and open the configuration file provided. This configuration file worked in Mikado 3.3, but now it doesn't work anymore because the connection to Excel is no more possible in Mikado. So you have first to change the connection to the file, and this snapshot is not correct because it's for exercise 2. But use the CSV button to select the CSV file. You can check the connection. If the connection is okay, you will have to update your queries because the syntax, SQL syntax, is not the same for querying an Excel file and a CSV file or an OpenOffice database. You have to remove the brackets and the dollar character, which you can find in the from clause of all your queries. If it's not clear, do not hesitate to ask me, I can help you. No? You have also to replace the format function by a toChar function, because the format function is very specific to Excel. It doesn't work when querying a CSV file or other database. This function appears in variable 28 and 29. So now you can check all the queries. If everything is green, you can save the configuration file and generate the XML files. So that's all for the alternative solution for Excel file with only one sheet. I have no time to show you the other solution for Excel file with several sheets. But this solution is well documented in the Mikado user manual. So if you need to implement this solution, refer to the Mikado user manual and do not hesitate to contact CDataNet Helpdesk to have support. So that's all for Mikado.